Hello and welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for joining us again. Could you be part of the 37 million? That's approximately how many Americans are affected by chronic kidney disease or CKD, and the vast majority of those people don't even know they have it. CKD is a very serious condition that often doesn't have any symptoms until it's advanced. But there is some new hope for patients, and our guest this afternoon, Dr. Neil Skolnick, professor of family and community medicine at the Sidney Kimmel Medical College of Thomas Jefferson University, joining us to talk more about CKD, some of the risk factors, how it's diagnosed, and a brand new way to treat CKD. I'm glad that you're here with us, doctor. Let's jump right in. First of all, what exactly is CKD? I said it's a very serious condition, but what exactly is it, and who's at risk?
Chronic kidney disease is so important, right? We know that the kidneys filter toxins from the blood, and really very simply, chronic kidney disease is when the kidneys start becoming less able to filter those toxins, and it goes through a set of stages that culminates in end-stage kidney disease with dialysis. The people at risk, we know that it is very common, right? 1 out of 7 people in the United States have it. But what's startling to people is that when we look at people over 65, 40% of people over 65 have it. And it's more common in certain groups, African Americans, people with hypertension, diabetes, obesity, all are at higher risk of having chronic kidney disease.
Now, those are some serious symptoms that would drive a person to go to their healthcare provider and say, you know, something is wrong, definitely. And as I mentioned, most people don't even know that they have chronic kidney disease. How exactly is CKD diagnosed, and why is it so important to seek that diagnosis? Maybe the fear of finding the source of some of those symptoms causes a person to delay seeking help. You know, as with any disease, early detection is key to a more favorable outcome.
Yeah, and something important about what you said, the unknown is always scary, and that's why we want to shed light on this. And so chronic kidney disease, what's the good news is if you catch it early, you can do something about it. It doesn't have to be as scary. And it's easy to catch early as long as we're thinking about it. So we do a simple blood test, simple urine test. And by so doing, we can detect chronic kidney disease early. It becomes part of our medical record. And we can follow patients with it. And after 20 years and nothing to do, now there's things that we can do to help people with CKD.
Well, I did mention in the outset of this this conversation that we were going to learn about a new way to treat CKD. So please enlighten us and let us in on why this new treatment is so important.
Well, it's critically important because I think we as doctors have not been paying that much attention to CKD for a long time because it's been 20 years since there's been a new development for effective treatment of CKD. But through a lot of research and scientific effort that has culminated just 2 weeks ago in the FDA approval of a new medicine, Farxiga, we're able now to slow the progression of chronic kidney disease, to slow it from getting worse in individuals who have chronic kidney disease, which is essentially why it's important to detect chronic kidney disease early and to do something about it when we see it, which is why I've partnered with AstraZeneca to get the word out about chronic kidney disease. Now, we know no one medicine is right for everybody, but that's why it's so important for patients to talk with their doctors, for we as doctors not to be insulted when patients come to us and say, hey, I'd like to hear more, talk more about it, or find out if I have chronic kidney disease, right? Because together we give the best health care.
Now, we here at Health Professional Radio certainly advocate early detection of any condition. What advice do you have for someone who is dealing with CKD or maybe thinks that they might have CKD?
Yeah, the critical thing here is early detection. So if you have it, ask your doctor what you can do to treat it. We just talked about the new approval by the FDA of a new medication. If you think you might have it or you're at risk, ask your doctor about screening for it. Again, that theme that is so important in all of our healthcare, that things work better when doctors and patients work together with the same goals to improve their health and outcomes.
And that is such a great message. Where can listeners go and learn more?
For people who want to learn more about chronic kidney disease and treatment, I'd refer them to Farziga.com, and there's a lot of information about chronic kidney disease and treatment of it. So it really has been a pleasure talking to you about it.
It's been a pleasure for me as well, and I really appreciate you joining us here on Health Professional Radio and giving us this information. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard, in conversation with Dr. Neil Skolnick, professor of family and community medicine at the Sidney Kimmel Medical College of Thomas Jefferson University. Audio copies of this program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, download at SoundCloud, and be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/healthprofessionalradio.